वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ एनर्जी ऑडिट एंड मैनेजमेंट. हियर इज प्रोफेसर लक्ष्मण माने. दिस इज लेक्चर ऑन एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी इन थर्मल यूटिलिटीज पार्ट 7, दैट इज स्टीम डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम एंड स्टीम ट्रैप्स. आई एक्नॉलेज माय सिंसियर थैंक्स टू द फॉलोइंग ऑथर and courtesy for being used these concepts to make this video session. In this session, you will be able to explain steam distribution system and you will also be able to explain steam trapping and types of steam traps. So let us discuss about steam distribution system. The steam distribution system is the essential link between the steam generator and the steam user. An efficient steam distribution system is essential if steam of the right quality and pressure is to be supplied in the right quantity to the steam using equipment. Hence, installation and maintenance of the steam system are important issues and must be considered at the design stage. The working pressure. The distribution pressure of steam is influenced by a number of factors, but it is limited by the maximum safe working pressure of the boiler and the minimum pressure required at the plant. As steam passes through the distribution pipework, it will inevitably lose pressure due to frictional resistance within the pipework and condensation within the pipework as heat is transferred to the environment. So here we will see now about basic steam distribution system. The steam generated in the boiler must be conveyed through pipework to the point where its heat energy is required. So here is a system in which boiler is a source of steam. From this steam is given to the different applications, say fan, process vessel, space heating system. After the use, steam is condensed and condensate is fed to the feed tank. With makeup water, it is supplied through the feed pump to the boiler and the cycle is completed. Features of steam piping. So here is a diagram of steam piping. General layout and location of steam consuming equipment is of great importance in efficient distribution of steam. So steam pipes should be laid by the shortest possible distance to avoid frictional losses rather than to follow a building layout or road, etc. So here in this image we see steam trap set. So we'll discuss about it now. Steam traps. The purpose of installing the steam traps is to obtain fast heating of the product and equipment by keeping the steam lines and equipment free of condensate, air and non-condensable gases. So here a steam trap is a valve device that discharges or removes condensate and air from the line or piece of equipment without discharging the steam. Following are the functions of steam traps. To discharge condensate as soon as it is formed, not to allow steam to escape, and to be capable of discharging air and other incondensable gases. Now we will see about types of steam traps. Steam traps are broadly classified into three types: thermostatic steam trap, mechanical steam trap, and thermodynamic steam trap. Thermostatic steam trap. These traps are temperature actuated. These are operated by change in the temperature. So on startup, the thermal element in steam trap is in contracted position with the valve wide open. Purging means removing condensate, air and other non-condensable gases. As the system warms up, heat generates pressure in the thermal element, causing it to expand and throttle the flow of hot condensate through the discharge valve. So this is the general working of thermostatic steam trap. When steam follows the hot condensate into the trap, the thermal element fully expands and closing the trap. Now the thermostatic steam trap includes following types of traps: float and thermostatic steam trap, bellows thermostatic steam trap, and bimetallic type steam trap. Float and thermostatic steam trap. In this, the ball float type trap, it operates by sensing the difference in density between the steam and condensate. In this case, condensate reaching the trap will cause the valve float to rise and lifting the valve off its seat and releasing condensate. So the valve is always flooded and neither steam nor air passes through it. It allows only condensate. So here in this image or animation, you can see this is red color of steam, blue color of condensate which is moving, and air is shown by yellow color. Bellows thermostatic steam trap. If condensate enter the trap during the system operation, it cools the element, contracting it off the seat and quickly discharging condensate. So in this diagram you can see when the valve is opened. So inside the steam trap housing there is bellows. So this is bellows. The bellows is connected to a plate which has, this is a plate which has a plunger attached to it. So this plunger is moving with the help of these bellows, contraction and expansion. When the bellows is contracted, the plunger location will move up and will allow air to pass through the valve. Further, when live steam reaches the boiler bellows, it extends downwards because of temperature increasing and forcing the valve to close. So this process is repeated until all air has been removed. The bellows then will remain extended and the valve closed during the sterilization cycle. Bimetallic type steam trap. Bimetallic steam trap operates on the same principle as a heating thermostat. It is connected to a valve, bends or distorts when subjected to a change in temperature. So here you can see bimetallic type. The valve closes. So this is a valve in closing condition. The valve closes up against a seat when steam is present. Because of steam, the valve is closed condition. The valve opens when condensate, air or other non-condensable gases are present. So this is a second diagram in which it is open and releasing the condensate and non-condensable gases from the system. Second major type is mechanical steam trap. This range of steam trap operates by sensing the difference in density between steam and condensate. These steam traps include two types, wall float steam traps and inverted bucket steam traps. Let us see ball float steam trap. So here is a diagram in which two positions are shown. It operates by sensing the difference in density between steam and condensate. So in a ball float steam trap, the ball rises when condensate is present and thus opening a wall which passes the denser condensate. In case of inverted bucket steam trap, here you can see this animation. This mechanism consists of an inverted bucket which is attached by a lever to a wall. So see, this is a wall. As essential part of trap is the small air vent hole. So here is a hole in the top of the bucket. Condensate flows under the bottom of bucket, filling the body and flowing away through the outlet. So here you can see this condensate vein is filling. It will move up this bucket and open the wall, and thus it will remove the air and non-condensable gases. As the gases will remove, here it will move down, wall will get closed. Third major type is thermodynamic steam trap. The trap operates by means of dynamic effect of flash steam as it passes through the trap. The only moving part is the disc above the flat face inside the control chamber or cap. So here, step 1, we can see on startup, incoming pressure raises the disc. So this is a disc, and cool condensate plus air is immediately discharged from the inner ring under the disc and out through three peripheral outlets. So here are the outlets. Then in step 2, hot condensate flowing through the inlet passage into chamber under the disc drops in pressure and releases flash steam moving at high velocity. This high velocity creates a low pressure area under the disc, drawing it toward the seat. So seat is moving in downward direction. Step 3. At this point, the flash steam is trapped in the upper chamber. This is upper chamber, and the pressure above the disc equals the pressure being applied to the underside. So this is the underside pressure of the disc from the inner ring. However, the top of the disc is subject to greater force than the underside because it has a greater surface area. Upper side is a greater surface area. So it is completely down, closing the openings. At the same time, the flash steam pressure builds up inside the chamber and above the disc, forcing it down against the incoming condensate until it sits on the inner and outer ring. So here you can see in this image. Now, step 4. Eventually, the trapped pressure in the upper chamber falls as the flash steam condenses. The disc is raised by the now higher condensate pressure. This is condensate pressure, and the cycle is repeated. So at the end of this session, you can explain steam distribution system and you can illustrate steam trapping and types of steam traps. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.